You would think a team who's undefeated, 13-0, would get some respect and people would be scared to play them or at least fear them. And well, you'd be wrong. And matter of fact, is nobody not only scared of Cincinnati, they don't even respect them or take them serious. I wouldn't go as too far as to saying people take them as a joke, but they kinda do. Currently, as to when I'm speaking and making this video, Cincinnati is a 13.5 point underdog against Alabama on December 31st. I'm going to repeat that. You have a team who hasn't lost a single game and they're almost a 14-point underdog. If you were someone who hasn't watched football and you saw they were a 14-point underdog, you'd be sitting there thinking, what the crap? But for college football fans like me and you watching this, we clearly get it 100%, no questions asked. Cincinnati by far is clearly the inferior team. At least in most people's eyes and opinions, everyone's saying, yo, they have no chance, Alabama's gonna mop the floor, and they're gonna be in the national championship. I'll touch on that a little later in this video, also gonna talk about Dan Lanning, who's leaving Georgia to be the head coach at Oregon, but the main topic we're gonna focus on is why Cincinnati is really in trouble. I'm not talking slightly in trouble or they should be worried, they're actually in trouble. If you're new to the channel or there's a bunch of you watching and you just haven't subscribed, I really appreciate if you join our family, hit that subscribe button and leave a like for more. And now without further ado, let's get into it. We'll start with the main topic first, and that'd be Cincinnati. Just like March Madness, I myself, like many others, we all love a good Cinderella story. However, this Cinderella story is over. It's no more playing Navy, Tulane, East Carolina, all those crappy schools. You're not playing with the big dogs. Cincinnati, you want to be considered with the big dogs, Georgia, Michigan, Alabama, Ohio State, Notre Dame, all those schools. Well, guess what? Now you're in there. There's a saying and quote I absolutely love. It says, everybody wants to be a beast until it's time to do what beasts do. That applies to almost everything, and especially this situation. Everybody wants to be considered on the same level as Alabama, Georgia, and they want to be up there with them until it's actually time to be up there with them. All throughout the season, we've seen surprisingly inconsistency from Alabama and also Cincinnati. I'm not going to spend too much time talking about the past games because they really don't matter. What I'm going to focus on is the matchup, and I'm going to get this out there now. Alabama and Nick Saban as a whole in unit, they thrive under pressure. It's the same thing I said going into the Georgia game. They love and relish the few opportunities they get to be doubted and be the underdog. Not only that, but when they play in a big time game, whether it's the championship, SEC championship, or the playoffs, they always perform good. There was one to two circumstances against Clemson a couple years ago where they didn't play good, but that's rare. That's one reason as to why Cincinnati's in trouble. The other is, they've never been to the playoffs and Alabama's been there almost every single year. The players on this Alabama team, they're used to being in these big time moments. For Cincinnati, they're not. Every single coach will tell you, whether it's high school, college, or the NFL, experience matters. Having experienced guys on your team, it's a game changer. They know what to expect and they're going to calm the younger guys down that haven't been there. Cincinnati, they don't have a single player that's been to the playoffs or played in this big of a game in their life. A lot of people won't understand what I'm about to say. If you play sports, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Alabama beats almost 90 to 95% of the teams they play before they even play the game. Yo, Matt, what do you mean by that? How do they beat them before they play? They do it mentally. It's the same thing that happens with Georgia. Georgia had a better team than Alabama, and even in years prior, they've had some teams better than Bama, but they can't get over the mental hump of beating them. The Georgia players have it engraved in their mind that they're not better than Bama when they are. I like to call it the fear factor. A lot of people fear the name and the brand of Alabama itself before the game even starts. Normally, the teams that have success with Alabama, they're not scared of them, and they're going to punch them right in the mouth. So with that being said, I am extremely worried that Cincinnati is going to lose this game before it even happens. Everyone in the country knows they're an underdog, they know they're an underdog, but they don't need to get it engraved in their mind that they're supposed to lose. They should think they're going to win. If I interviewed every single Cincinnati player and told them to be honest if they thought they were better than Bama, I can guarantee you not every player is going to say yes they are. On the flip side for Alabama, I know 100% those players firmly believe they're way better than Cincinnati. Football just isn't how strong you are and how talented you are, it's mental. There is some good news for Cincinnati. They got the talent, so they shouldn't worry about that. If you want to be technical about it, yes, Alabama has way more 4- and 5-star recruits, but Cincinnati, they have their fair share of good players. I really like their tight end. I think he's going to be utilized a lot, and their quarterback Desmond Ridder, he's not the greatest of all time, but he can get the job done. Their running back Jerome Ford, if a lot of you don't know this, he's a former backup running back for Alabama. Part of their game that concerns me a lot is they're a really good running team and you're not going to run on Alabama. I can guarantee you that. It's going to be up to Desmond Ridder to beat Alabama and I don't see that happening. Their two outstanding defensive backs, Sauce Gardner and Kobe Bryant, yes, they're outstanding, but they've never played a wide receiver core like Alabama. Unfortunately, John Metchie can't play, but Jameson Williams, if you can hold him to under 100 yards, that's a W. Just because Mechie's out, don't think some of those other receivers aren't going to step up. You got to realize the guys on the bench for Alabama, they're 4- and 5-star recruits. It's not like when Mechie goes out and they can only throw it to Williams, there's other receivers they plug in. I don't want you to think I'm taking Kobe Bryant and Sauce Gardner lightly. All I'm saying is they never played somebody like Jameson Williams. I do got to give Cincinnati's defense some credit. They got one of the best defenses in the country if you go off of stats. I don't really like to use numbers when I evaluate a team's offense or defense, but I couldn't really use their competition either. Yeah, I get it, you're shutting down some of these teams you're playing, but they're not even good. Their defense isn't awful and I would consider them good, I just don't know if they're great. It also brings me to this question, does it even matter if their defense is that good? Look what Bryce Young did to Georgia's defense. That was the number one defense in the country, so if he can do that to them, I mean, who's to say he couldn't drop 50 against Cincinnati? Let me put it this way. No team in the SEC or any team this year has been able to slow down Bryce Young in that receiver core, so why should I believe Cincinnati's going to, even if they do have good defensive backs? I don't see it happening, but I will say I wouldn't be shocked if Bryce had some problems here and there. I'm going to throw this in there too, a lot of people aren't even talking about. Alabama's running backs, their play this year, it's been wishy-washy. Their offensive line has also been iffy at times. However, I'm going to predict right now, I think surprisingly, I'm getting a weird feeling about it, Alabama's going to be able to run the ball in Cincinnati whenever they want to. I don't think they're going to smash it down their throat and run on every play, but I think Brian Robinson and Trey Sanders, some of the other backups, they're going to have an okay night. Alabama has physical linemen. Evan Neal is going to be a top 5 draft pick. They could have some success, so look out for that. When it's all said and done, what's going to be the key factor of this game? Desmond Ridder. Can he make enough throws to beat Alabama? I don't think so. I don't think he's a great quarterback. I think he's a good quarterback who can be great at times. Nothing about his game stands out to me or wows me all that much to where I'm going to say, oh yeah, he could shock Alabama or beat Georgia or Michigan. Cincinnati's known for their defense and known for their running back play, and your defense isn't going to stop Bryce Young, and your running back isn't going to have success against Alabama's rushing defense. Although Alabama's defense has been really bad at times this year, their running defense is one of the top 4 or 5 in the country. You got to take into account, this was the worst time to play Alabama and probably the worst matchup they could have got. Alabama as a unit is at an all-time high and it seems like everything's clicking. Could Cincinnati win this game? Could they pull off the upset? I mean, yeah, anything's possible. On a serious note, I would be flabbergasted if they won, and it would arguably be one of the biggest upsets in college football history. I get they're a 4th-ranked team, but come on now, nobody's giving them a chance. I'll probably do a video making my predictions on these games as we get closer, but right now, I'm getting this weird feeling, 31-20, I'm going to predict that's the final score, Alabama wins 31-20. That seems like a good and even score to me. I think it's going to be somewhat competitive, but Alabama's never going to get too worried. The main reason I think Cincinnati's going to have a bad day, they haven't played teams that hit as hard, run as fast, do everything like Alabama does. Alabama is the cream of the crop, it doesn't get too much better when you're talking about college football. They're not used to playing a team of this caliber. Sure, you beat Notre Dame, but come on. Now, Notre Dame's not even elite. I truly feel like Cincinnati is in more trouble than what some people are talking about. Let me know your thoughts on that down below. Before we end off this video, I do want to speak on the Dan Lanning situation. If you have no idea who he is, he's a coordinator for Georgia. If you were keeping up with this as a Georgia fan or as a college football fan, you know how weird it was. 2 to 3 days ago, there was speculation saying that he was going to be the new coach, but it wasn't announced. And then shortly, not too long ago, it was made official. I can't find it, and I can't remember where I saw this or heard it, but I'm almost 99% sure he's going to continue to coach Georgia until their playoffs over. If that's true, and I believe it is, that is a huge W, because if they had to replace a coordinator to his caliber, they'd be completely lost. I don't have too much to say about it. I don't know too much about him, if I'm being quite honest, but I'm hearing he's a good coach and he's going to do good at Oregon. I guess we'll have to wait and see. Let me know your thoughts on this down below. As crazy as the college football world has been the past couple of weeks, it's starting to slow down. I'm sure that won't last long and we'll hear some crazy news, and you know we're going to talk about it. So hit that subscribe button if you like what you see. Leave a like, do all that nice stuff. Without further ado, let's be great about y'all. Peace.